Hey everybody, it's Pastor Jeff, and I just wanted to come and talk to you for a couple of minutes about the reference that I made to Francis Chan in yesterday's sermon. I think it's important that you get a little bit more of the story and some backup that I pray will really help. I'm going to send you, attached to this video, some feedback from a ministry called Wretched that will literally walk with you through Francis Chan's response, and that's important. It's Francis Chan's response to the controversy that has been raised based on his sharing the stage and perhaps a degree of his witness with those whose testimony and ministries clearly go against the biblical teaching that Francis Chan has been so long known for and championing. So here's what I want you to understand, and it's this simple. I love Francis Chan. Those of you that know me and know our ministry know that he has long since been used as a regular, strong, consistent voice in our ministry. And in many ways, I've attached our witness to his witness. We've endorsed his ministry with our ministry. And it's because of my great love and strong usage of his ministry that I was compelled yesterday and am compelled here again today to draw these clear lines of distinction. There is in no way a lack or a loss of love for Francis Chan. I am not in any way calling him heretical or dangerous. What I am saying, and where I do agree with what you'll see with the folks from Wretched, is that there seems to have been at best a lapse in judgment, a disconnection from the teaching of not only 1 John chapter 1 verse 10, but the broader understanding of influence and our witness. You know, it's not enough to say, well, I'm going amongst the false teachers and teaching truth for the glory of God, when those false teachers are going to envelop you in a broader context, and thereby your witness gets used by them to help them as they try to tell the world, look, even somebody like Francis Chan is in agreement with us. Look, we're all sending you the same message. If you know me and you're familiar with our Bridge ministry, you know that protecting your witness is and has been and will continue to be amongst the most important teaching and priorities that we bring forward. Because after your salvation, your witness is the single most valuable thing you have in the kingdom. And so my prayer is that you understand this, that you'll pray with and for what is happening in this whole controversy, and that you'll see God be glorified as I pray Francis Chan will come forward and clarify what he has done. I believe at this point to correct what he has done, and in so doing, come back to that place that is the both and of wanting to reach the lost, of wanting to help the deceived, of lovingly correcting and if need be boldly rebuking the false teachers, while never for a moment sacrificing the purity and the power of our own witness. That's my prayer. Again, I've used Francis's materials as recently as just 2 or 3 weeks ago in a sermon. I continue to tell people that the greatest single sermon I have ever heard was shared by Francis Chan. And even if he's made a lapse in judgment, it doesn't take away from the truths that have been shared. My reservation and my concern and the reason for my announcement and my shift in using Francis Chan's materials is based on the fact that not everybody is going to be able to discern the difference between what is from the past and what may be a current season of perhaps losing a sense of judgment or discernment. And I just cannot risk my ministry, my witness, being used of the enemy to draw others away. And I encourage you again to take that same posture. That's what I shared yesterday, to understand who is surrounding you as you serve the Lord in His cloud of witnesses here today. And that if and when somebody is boldly and consistently teaching wrong, you do not engage with them. You do not allow your witness to be poured into theirs. And at the same time, we want to remember that we are to love everybody within the family of God. And if and when we disagree on second or third tier issues, we're family. And so whether or not somebody handles the type of worship music in a church differently than we do, or if they may look upon other secondary issues in a way differently than we do, we don't divide over that. That's the family of God with differences of opinion. But when we begin to talk about a different Jesus, when we disengage from the authority and the role of God's holy word, when we no longer are pursuing God's will, but the will of man, these are areas that we do divide over without apology. In fact, we should stress the clarity with which we are separating. And I pray that's what this is doing today. Listen, friends, the last thing in the world I want to do is put a shadow over some of my personal heroes. And Francis has been one. And at the same time, as an under-shepherd, the last thing I want to do is turn a blind eye to a current crisis or concern because of my love for man or out of fear for man's response to our pursuit and our following of Christ. I've said to you many times before, there's a great tension in the Christian life. This is one of those times, and this is one of those tensions. And I pray that you'll allow the Word of God in its full context and the will of God in its enlightening of what true Christ-likeness looks like, and the ways of God as are clearly designed to construct our ministry and our witness. I pray that the Word of God, the will of God, and the ways of God will continue to fuel and filter and refine you and me, all for God's glory and all by God's grace. Amen and amen.